Jedi, the Council is pleased to see you've arrived on Alderaan. Until recently, Alderaan was a part of the Republic. Today, it's on the brink of collapse. Shortly after seceding, both the Queen and the heir to the Alderaanian throne were assassinated. A usurper, Boris Ulgo, stepped into power, setting off a civil war.
I assume one of the Jedi Masters is here.
Master Sidoni Garen, one of the Jedi Order's finest strategists and diplomats, dropped out of contact briefly while on Alderaan. She's made contact since, but was evasive about her silence. Master Sidoni is brokering a peace on Alderaan. If she is suffering from the plague, it could jeopardize the entire peace process.
Do you have any leads on her location?
Master Sidoni was working with the head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, Hala Morgana. Find Master Sidoni and make sure she is well, that the peace process is not in jeopardy.
Welcome, Jedi. I'm Hala Morgana, head of House Organa's diplomatic corps, and this is my younger, more handsome brother, Lou.
Please, Hala, you do yourself an injustice. Your age gives you a stately difference.
If I wasn't wearing my extra years around my waist, I might agree. Now, Jedi, how can I help you?
I'm looking for Master Sidoni Garen. I believe she may be ill.
She seemed fine last I spoke with her. Well, you just missed her. She's at the Peace Summit. A Peace Summit on Alderaan. Imagine that. But I'll call her. The location of the summit is a secret for obvious reasons. But I'm sure she'd welcome your assistance.
Hala Morgana, I'm sorry, but I'm very busy right now. The summit is just getting underway.
The Jedi Council sent me to help with the peace process.
You're Master Yuan's student, aren't you? It's wonderful the Council sent you to assist me, but this is a very delicate process, with no place for a Padawan.
I passed my trials, and I think the Council knows what it's doing.
Only official representatives of the Houses may attend the summit. What would the other Houses think if another Jedi from House Organa showed up? And I don't have time to debate, if you'll excuse me.
Master Sidoni, I'm sorry, Jedi. That's really not like her.
All the more reason why I need to get into that summit.
Yes, well, Master Sidoni said that only representatives can go. Unfortunately, Organa's representative is already there.
Hal, House Teral, you know, with the beautiful daughter. Couldn't our Jedi friend represent them?
Huh, my brother is a genius. House Teral is desperate for a representative, but the usurper Ulgo destroyed their hopes. If you could help them defend themselves against their enemies and return them to glory, I'm sure they'd make you their delegate.
Hopefully, House Teral can find use for me.
I'm sure they will. They are in dire straits.
You'll find Lord Teral in his house's last holdings, an enclave near Ulgo lands and Kilik nests. I will let them know you're coming.
And beware the Kiliks. Those insect men have terrible tempers.
Guapuntacho, Chubalong Haku, Yasa un Kubas, Taja Bakta Tunbunko.
I am pleased I could help.
Wantahumpa, Muri Rava Fupa Jipampa Wula. A king sali kikava dumpa stupa.
Let's get to it, shall we?
A king sali kikava dumpa stupa. Wada blota wi jawa o wama wanga matuske buka kampak niji tonka yiliska chanaga.
Are you Lord Terrell? I'm here to become your delegate to the peace summit.
Jedi, yes. Organa told me you'd be coming, but, well, this is, well, it's complicated. The whole house needs to approve a new delegate, and, well, they say they won't approve a stranger. Yes, of course, but House Tyrael has fallen so hard, we don't even have the strength to hope. It will take more than my word to convince them.
It is my privilege as a Jedi to serve House Tyrael in whatever way I can.
Really? Well, all right then. After our original delegate was murdered and Ulgo drove us back into this hole, I'd almost given up hope myself.
Just tell the Jedi our plan, Father.
Right. House Tyrael's current position is precarious. Our enemy, House Ulgo, seeks our destruction. Their army is at our gate. House Tyrael needs a strong ally if we are to survive. We need Haas Organa.
An alliance with Organa seems doable.
We had hoped so. We proposed a marriage alliance to House Organa. My daughter Fasha would marry Lu Organa.
But House Tyrael is weak, and powers within Organa. Fear we'd drag them down with us.
We need to prove to Organa that House Tyrael can defend itself against its enemies.
We need a plan. Tell me, what are your resources?
I'm afraid you're our only source, Jedi. As I've said, House Ulgo's forces are at our gates, threatening to drive us out of our last holding. But Ulgo's commanding general, Astor Vox, is a mercenary with a loose definition of loyalty. If we can reach him, turn him, we can break the siege.
I will begin negotiations with Astor Vox immediately.
We have no time to waste. I will contact House Organa the moment I hear that the siege is broken.
Come representing House Tyrael. They want you to give up this siege and join them.
Well, isn't this a surprise? The Jedi have decided to involve themselves in Alderaanian politics. You must be pretty sure of yourself to walk into a room of highly trained commandos. But you should know that I don't do business with just anyone.
I am a Jedi. My word is good, as is House Tyrael's.
I'm sure it is, but that's not my concern. The battlefield is the only true test of a person's worth. War, bloodshed, these are the fires and forges of greatness. I only negotiate with my equals. Besides, my men are itching for sport. Best a pack of my warhounds, we can talk.
You'd best keep your promise.
Excellent. I've not had the pleasure of seeing a Jedi in action. Release the dogs! Think, boys. That was a little too easy, wasn't it?
Aye. Let's see a real challenge.
I trusted in the Force to see me through.
I'm sure you did. Not that I expected anything less from a Jedi.
Those dogs were old, weren't they, boys?
You need to do better than defeat a pack of geriatric mutts. No, you need a real challenge. What'll it be, boys?
Droids! Droids! Droids!
Droids it is, then. These are the best Ulgo has. Beat them, and we'll talk.
If that is what I must do to earn your respect, so be it.
Droids! Activate attack protocols. Target Jedi. Excellent, excellent. I like your form, Jedi. But I'm not entirely convinced yet. Sure, you can beat a couple of dumb machines, but what about Ulgo's finest warriors? Smart, fast, highly trained, and hardened by battle.
Ringhorn's Luke Sark, Trakva Grenok, Luke Drachos.
On my honor, this is the last time. Beat my champions, and we'll talk.
I trust you will keep your word this time.
On my honor. Now, boys, show this Jedi what you're made of. Impressive, Jedi. I didn't think House Tyrall had the resources left to recruit such a powerful ally. No hard feelings. If you knew how many fools come by offering me jobs.
House Tyrall wants your loyalty, and they want your army to stand down.
I'll give you credit for being direct. You can tell House Tyrall that my answer is yes. It's been fun working for House Ulgo, but there's no glory in working for the biggest army on the planet. I'll call off my troops and meet with Lord Tyrall immediately. Don't worry, I know the way.
Jedi, thank goodness I've reached you. There's good news and bad news. The good news is everyone's heard how you impressed Astor Vox and broke the siege, including Organa. They've agreed to the marriage alliance. Now the bad news. Lu Organa has been kidnapped.
Then we have to get him back.
Exactly. The kidnappers were from Ulgo's ally, House Rist, Alderaan's most deadly assassins. An Organa-Tyrall alliance would be disastrous to Ulgo. They must have ordered Rist to kidnap Lu Organa to stop the alliance.
I'll rescue Lu Organa. I promise.
Be careful, but hurry. We need to beat the Organa attack, or everything falls apart.
Thought they were going to kill me. House Tyrall sent you, didn't they? They called about an alliance. I was riding to meet them and... Well, thank goodness you're here.
Do you know what reason Rist had for kidnapping you?
No. No idea. Maybe something to do with the alliance? I was going to meet with House Tyrall to discuss the marriage alliance when these assassins swooped in and knocked me off my Thranta. I woke up here. But were they trying to prevent the Alliance? Who would want to do that?
Without the Marriage Alliance, I can't get to the summit. Maybe someone doesn't want me to go.
Who would care if you went to the summit? Though now that you mention it, as I lost consciousness, they were talking about Master Sidoni. But how could she be involved? It has to be a frame job. It must be.
I believe Master Sidoni is very ill, but if I can get to the summit, I hope to help her.
I just want to trust Master Sidoni. I'm sorry. My head. I still get these pains from the fall. I can't leave here until I know if Master Sidoni was involved. The kidnappers used to go into the other room to contact their employer. I'm sure we'll find a comm device there. We just need to see who they've been calling.
I appreciate your desire to help, and I will be sure to praise your zeal to Master Yuan. But I am extremely busy right now. I can't afford interruptions.
Why is your holo frequency in House Rist's computer?
I would assume it's because Rist was invited to the summit. Now, if you'll excuse me, Jedi, I have very important work to do.
Wait, Master Sidoni! I don't understand. What was her frequency doing here?
I assure you, Master Sidoni's not herself.
Should she be leading the summit, then? She could do something terrible. Please, I need to get out of this place. My head is killing me, and I keep looking over my shoulder expecting more assassins. I'll see that the Organa-Tural Alliance is finalized, and that you get to the summit.
I don't understand. Why would you want to risk it?
Lord Tural, without risk, there can be no glory. The only way to avoid risk is to avoid war. But that's not very effective or fun, is it?
No, I suppose it isn't. Ah, Jedi, welcome back. General Vox and I were just discussing strategy. We haven't stood this proud since our house was young and building its first alliance with House Pantir. Thank you, Jedi.
The Jedi way is to serve.
You have our gratitude. Lu Organa and my daughter Fasha are getting acquainted as we speak. I spoke with the rest of House Tural, and the decision was unanimous. You are our new delegate. Congratulations!
Now I need to get to the summit and find Master Sidoni.
I have the packet the last delegate was supposed to use, but I don't understand its contents. Some coordinates and a data spike. It appears that you need to go to those coordinates and do something with the data spike?
I just hope she's not planning any tricks.
Just one moment, Jedi, if I may. We would like to ask one last thing. There will never be peace for House Tural as long as House Ulgo exists. If you're able to use your influence as a Jedi to convince the summit to strip House Ulgo, ensure they never hold a title again, we'd show our gratitude.
I don't want to do anything that will destabilize the peace.
Please, Jedi. House Tural has security now, but we still require justice. Good luck at the summit. I hope you find Master Sidoni well, and that all goes smoothly.
I have Master Sidoni's permission.
Habanotase Makipuna, Malituta Odmishka.
So here it is, laid bare before you, the irrefutable evidence. House Ald has been conspiring against House Organa for years, preying on their good trust. House Thule is the reason the Pantir heir was assassinated. And House Ulgo is merely a puppet of House Rist.
Lies! All lies!
There are holographic recordings, documents. You can't argue with hard evidence.
We trusted you! How dare you! You will meet our armies on the field of battle!
Master Sidoni, what have you done?
You wouldn't understand. I do this for the good of the galaxy.
Master Sidoni, you have a sickness that's altering your mind.
I have suppressed my illness, overcome it through reason. I am thinking, as I always have, in strategy, in variables and outcomes. I have calculated the future, and for the galaxy to have peace, there must be war on Alderaan. I will not be shaken from this course.
I'm sorry, Master Sidoni, but I can't let that happen.
You are too late. All the pieces are already in place.
You're a fouler liar than House Rist.
House Rist takes exception to that characterization. Murderer.
That was 30 years ago.
We had an alliance.
House Organa has heard enough. It's clear to us that there can be no other course but war.
Master Sidoni set you up for this. She would see you all destroyed.
This child is barely more than a Padawan. Disregard him.
Master Sidoni is the only one telling any truth at this summit. Don't insult her integrity.
You would defend her, Organa. You've always been a little too friendly with the Republic.
At least they didn't murder the heir to the throne.
We didn't murder anyone. Rist did.
Yes, Rist put that usurper on the throne, but you ordered the hit.
Usurper! Our reign is as legitimate as any other!
How can you judge each other when you've all committed the same crimes?
Easy for you to say, Jedi, you don't have any stake in any of this.
These accusations go back 30 years! 30 years of betrayal and treachery!
If you can't work together and trust each other at a peace summit, where can you?
Exactly. We can't trust anyone.
No. Wait. Doesn't the Jedi have a point? We came here to make peace.
That was before we learned each other's true colors.
Was that really such a revelation? Every one of us was guilty of something. Surely we expected everyone else to be doing the same.
No. There must be war on Alderaan. The darkness is coming, and I must stop it.
Master Sidoni?
Listen to her! She wants war!
Fight the illness, Master Sidoni. Come back to the light.
Jedi, if you will not agree to be silent, then I will silence you myself. The darkness is coming, Jedi. War must rage on Alderaan for 50 years, and only then can we put an end to the darkness. But you haven't won yet. Once you're out of the way, I'll make them see. I failed you. I tried to keep the darkness from coming, but I failed.
You're not the first person to mention Parcanis.
It's my fault Parcanis died. Malachor III. I miscalculated. He had to be left behind. He died because of me. Vivicar! My head! Please, I can't black out his voice any longer. You must kill me to silence him.
I won't kill you. But you don't need to hear his voice again, either.
Jedi? What? How did you... I don't understand. My mind is clear again. And you're... weak. Will you be all right? What did you do?
It's a shielding ritual. It should keep Lord Vivicar's voice out of your head for a while.
Thank you, Jedi. I only hope the sacrifice wasn't too great. For a while, I thought I was able to block Lord Vivicar's voice from my mind. If you hadn't been there with your calm sense, I don't know what would have happened.
Master Seo will be wondering how you are.
I will contact the Jedi Council. I'm sure they'll want a full explanation.
I think I can safely speak for all present when I say that the summit applauds your efforts.
Indeed. But I have to say, Jedi, I'm at a loss as to how to proceed from here.
Let there be a truce, and let the summit reconvene at a later date to work on a formal peace agreement.
The summit will reconvene at a later date to discuss the details of a peace agreement. Thank you again, Jedi.
Jedi, I hear the summit has agreed to continue peace talks.
Thankfully, the delegates saw reason.
Thankfully indeed. We all owe a debt of thanks to you and Master Sidoni. My only regret is there's no talk of removing House Olgo's noble status and lands once the war is over.
I didn't want to risk undoing the peace by inciting another conflict.
That was probably the wisest course. I just can't feel safe as long as Olgo commands an army. But what am I saying? House Tyrell is far safer now with peace in view and Organa as an ally than we ever were. And I have you to thank.
You are most welcome.
You've done House Tyrell an invaluable service. I hope you will come visit us again.
Master Sidoni just checked in. She seems well, but very frustrated with herself. She reports that you were able to prevent war from breaking out on Alderaan, however. You've once again done very good work in a tense situation, Jedi.
I did my best, given the situation.
The Council has come to expect nothing less of you. Tell me, did you learn anything new about the Plague Master, Lord Vivicar?
I wish I could say I had.
I see. Master Sidoni was the last of the Lost Masters, and yet Vivicar still eludes us. Return to us here on Tython immediately, and we will discuss what you have learned. Lord Vivicar cannot remain hidden forever.
You summoned me, Master Seo.
Welcome home.
I wish we could greet you with better news.
Despite using every avenue available to us, we are no closer to finding Lord Vivicar.
Actually, I believe we are. A common thread binds all the plague victims. The loss of Parcanus Tark and Malachor III. Vivicar's influence forced the sick masters to relive their failures on Malachor. This is revenge. Personal revenge. Only one man would have that much anger and pain. The man who was left behind. I believe Lord Vivicar is Parcanus Tark.
Jedi, Parcanus is dead.
Far from it, Jarek.
Yuan? I told those Padawans to keep an eye on you. You must rest.
No. My pupil, my fellow Jedi, deserves to hear the truth about Malachor.
You're ill, Master Yuan. Don't speak more than you have to.
Malachor III isn't just strong in the dark side. The planet is the resting place of the Sith Lord, Terak Morraj. Our work on Malachor woke Morraj's spirit. One by one we fell under his power. The things we did still haunt me.
The Noeticons on Coruscant said that Terak Morraj originally created the plague.
Then I've been punished appropriately. We paid a terrible price to break free of him. Harkannis was the youngest and weakest. We had to abandon him to Malachor's darkness. His sacrifice allowed the rest of us to escape, but it seems he survived and has taken Murridge's dark path.
You couldn't have predicted this.
I must make amends. I have a plan to help you find Vivicar. If the plague created a link between my mind and his, your shielding ability may allow me to use that link to find him.
No. You're already weak from the plague, Yuan. This could kill you.
Vivicar won't get the chance. I'll be between him and my master.
It's our best chance to find Vivicar.
Very well, Yuan. But we will monitor the ritual, and your former Padawan must stay at your side.
Thank you, Sio. I will go to the meditation chamber to prepare. Please meet me there when you're ready. Thank you for coming. I have made all the preparations for the ritual to find Lord Vivicar. I plan to create a connection between us, using your shielding ability. If it was Parcanus, this should work. Drawing on your strength, I will invert the link between myself and Vivicar, and use it to sense his location.
Don't expose yourself to Lord Vivicar's influence longer than necessary.
I won't, for your sake as well as mine. There are risks. For one, the shielding you gave me on Coruscant will be severed. I don't know what will happen then. It's possible I could die once your shield is gone.
You must resist, Master Yuan. Don't give Vivicar another victory.
With your strength to sustain me, we will do what we can. No matter what happens, you must give me as much time as possible. Reversing the link may be a long process. Let us begin. Yes. Yes, it's working. I can feel his mind, and I can feel...
She can feel the power that she's challenging. There is no hope. Jedi, you don't look as strong as you did last time we spoke. Yuan has drained your strength and made herself vulnerable to me. Still arrogant and reckless.
You were once Parcanus Tark, a brave Jedi. You could be that man again.
The past means nothing. All that matters is the future, which doesn't involve you. See how Yuan's will crumbles before mine. Fitting that two of my enemies will destroy each other.
It worked. Listen, Lord Vivicar, he's out in deep space on some sort of vessel. Here, take the coordinates. He surrounded himself with defenses. Send this. It's his code. It will give you time to get aboard. No, the darkness. Vivicar's will is too strong. I can't hold on. Please, kill me. End it now.
There's a better way, Master.
Ah, the darkness. It's gone. But you look exhausted. You have sacrificed so much for me.
Hopefully, Vivicar should no longer be able to influence you.
Your shielding ability has driven him from my mind. Thank you. I must rest. Please, go to Master Sio and the Council. They should hear of what we've learned.
The ritual was a success. Lord Vivicar is out in uncharted space, but he knows I'm coming.
Now only your shielding talent can stop him.
You've shown great fortitude and saved your master despite the odds. But Lord Vivicar will have made preparations, and he still has his greatest weapon, the plague.
Now that I know who he really is, I could return Vivicar to the light.
A noble thought, but don't take unnecessary risks. Your shielding ability is our only hope. Go to the coordinates quickly, before Vivicar strikes back. And Jedi, may the Force be with you.
I wasn't sure if you'd be foolish enough to come aboard, Jedi. But I can sense your presence.
And I sense a man tormented by the past.
You are blinded by the light side. You can't understand what you face. Come to me, Jedi. I'll show you how light can be snuffed out.
I endured it.
Pain makes us stronger. And the pain I have endured is beyond your comprehension. That is why I have won. You will understand soon, if you live that long.
Your power and tactics have got you this far, Jedi, but no further. This battle was decided before you stepped aboard.
I'm tired of your delusions. Explain yourself.
My plague isn't just a disease. It siphons power from its victims. with the proper rituals, that power can be channeled. Soon, the combined strength of your masters will make me the most powerful Force adept who has ever lived.
Not if I have anything to say about it.
You can't defeat me, Jedi. This face, this Vivicar, he is just another skin to be shed. Parcanus offered himself to me on Malachor III to crush the order that destroyed us. He embodied my spirit.
I am no lost Jedi, no ordinary Sith Lord. I am Terak Morrig.
Help me stop this monster, Parcanus, or you'll just be another of his victims.
No one can oppose me. I am beyond flesh, beyond death.
I will crush you, Jedi, and your shattered body will fuel my rebirth!
Impressive, Jedi. You might even have triumphed, but my victory is already complete. My plague has spread farther than you can imagine. Jedi Masters across the galaxy are succumbing to it as I speak. The plague binds these Masters to me. Hundreds of them. The heart and soul of your order.
Free those masters, Morrig, now.
And if I refuse, will you cut us down? Kill me, and you will kill every master I have ever infected. Everyone. Shielded or not, they are still bound to me. But what choice do you have? You cannot let me live, and I am deathless. Your shielding talent cannot harm me. You've lost.
No matter what, Parcanus will be freed from you, Morrig.
Still alive. You spared me. My mind is clearer now. But it was your duty to kill me and destroy Morrig.
Too many Jedi have been lost already, including Parcanus Tarkk.
Yes. Parcanus was lost. But perhaps he deserves another chance. I cannot return to the Order. But Tython has its hidden places. Its forests. I could find peace there. I could go home. But first, Jedi, listen. Take this warning in exchange for my life. You can't trust the Order or the Republic. You may be their hero now, but they will abandon you too. Remember that.
We felt it. A massive shift in the Force. The masters you saved have reported a sudden improvement in their condition. The plague is over, thanks to you. And I sensed Parkanis talk for the first time in many years. How can that be?
When he comes back to Tython, he can answer all your questions.
We persuaded the Republic to divert a starship to your location, just in case. The crew can bring Vivicar back to us. Thank you for all you have done. The Jedi Order owes its survival to you. Please, return to us on Tython. We wish to thank you in person, and we have a special reward for you.
We've been awaiting your return. Please, step forward.
You have saved untold lives through your defeat of Lord Vivicar and the destruction of the plague.
There's a title reserved for the most prestigious among us, whose wisdom and skill safeguard the galaxy. It hasn't been bestowed in thousands of years.
But you have proved worthy. Now, the Council names you Barsan Thor, Warden of the Order.
How many Jedi have been named Barsan Thor?
In all our millennia of history, you will be the third to carry the title. And not a moment too soon. We have need of you.
We have received word that the Republic is facing a new threat.
I stand ready for anything, Master.
We need time to prepare a war council. The Supreme Chancellor himself will be attending.
Take time to rest. And you should record your journey in the Jedi Archives. History must know of your actions. Return to us when you feel ready. For now, the entire Order will know there is a new Barsan Thor among us.
Warden Lambasask. Warden Lambasask. Mothrask. Undapolua.
We hunt side by side, Quizen. Whatever my score, you share it.
Your Nord Master Shivir Skarsnik.